Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really, that's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too, because I'm just chilling down here in the lair with the OG iMac. And the reason why I'm doing that is because a new iMac for 2020 is just on the horizon. So according to the Mac Rumors Buyer's Guide, which by the way, amazing resource, the iMac hasn't been updated in about 400 days, and the average time span between updates is 383. So I think it's fair to say a new one is coming up pretty soon. Now, Apple's first iMac was released in 1998. That's the one that's chilling down here with me. And every so often, probably about twice a year, they would release updated features and speed bumps and all that stuff. And 4 years later, they introduced the new G4 design. And every so often, every 3-4 years or so, they would release a new design. But we have not had a new design for the iMac since 2012. This is where they took the 2009 design and added a little bit of thinnovation to it. Personally, I still think the design looks good, but I think 8 years is a little long to stick with the same design. So I would like to see a new design for the 2020 iMac, but my hopes are kind of low. I don't think we're gonna see that until 2021, because in 2021, the rumor is that Apple is gonna be transitioning to ARM processors. So with that big transition, I think Apple's also gonna do new designs for certain things, like with the iMac. But on the flip side, some people are saying we might actually see the new design this year after all. Mark Gurman said that a substantial refresh for the iMac is planned for this year, and there's also rumors about a 23-inch iMac. This makes sense because Apple seems to be bumping up screen sizes lately, like what they did with the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and what they might do with the rumored 14.1-inch MacBook Pro. But for fun, I decided to create my own iMac 2020 concept anyway, and we'll talk about it more as we go through the features and changes. So CoinX, a reliable source in the leaker community, posted a tweet saying iMac/Mac Mini soon. We already saw the Mac Mini update. It was a small update, but it was still there, so we can check that off the list. But nothing on the iMac yet, so it's probably right around the corner. As for the internal changes, we're probably gonna see Intel's 10th generation processors inside of it, called Ice Lake, and we might see more cores. I would like to see a 10-core configuration, but I have no confirmation of that yet. But if Apple can cram 8 cores into their laptop, I think they can cram more cores into the non-Pro iMac, because the iMac Pro goes up to 18, so that would be nice. But 8 cores is still plenty. Here's an interesting thing though. We all know Apple uses Intel processors for their Macs, but inside of the 10.15.4 beta, there were references to AMD APUs. That probably got some people excited, but honestly, I wouldn't get your hopes up. That stuff was probably in there just for testing purposes. Apple did something similar with the PowerPC transition, where the early versions of Mac OS X were made for PowerPC, but just in case, they were also compiling Mac OS X for Intel.
Mac OS X has been leading a secret double life for the past 5 years. In that building right there, we've had teams doing the just in case scenario. I can confirm the rumors that every release of Mac OS X has been compiled for both PowerPC and Intel. This has been going on for the last 5 years.
Another reason why you shouldn't get your hopes up, and like, by the way, I don't care if you like AMD or Intel, they're both great, but another reason why you shouldn't get your hopes up about Apple putting AMD CPUs or APUs in their Macs is because starting in 2021, we're gonna see them transition to their own custom processors based on the ARM architecture. They've been doing this for years, starting with the iPad and then they moved to the iPhone. They've been testing this stuff out in those devices forever. And this also led to some very weird rumor that I'm very skeptical about, where Apple is going to release or announce a high-end gaming Mac at WWDC 2020. I'm sorry, I'm not used to hearing the words Mac and gaming in the same sentence. I couldn't keep a straight face. Either way, I think there's a misunderstanding here. Still kind of a fun rumor nonetheless, but I don't think that's in Apple's best interest right now to release a gaming machine. Okay, so next thing. There's talk about Apple moving to mini LEDs for the display, and that would be cool to see that in the 2020 iMac, but I don't think we're gonna see it this early. In fact, the earliest we're probably gonna see mini LEDs in Apple products is in late 2020, probably in the iPad Pro. But as for the iMac, we're probably not gonna see mini LEDs in that until 2021. What exactly are mini LEDs? Well, these really tiny lights help with higher contrast ratios, and they also help reduce blooming on images. But they're also potentially gonna be lower cost than OLED. So that's something to look forward to. And if you wanna know more about that, Linus did a good video about it. Go ahead and check it out. We're not gonna go down that rabbit hole. Another thing we will, I'm saying 99% sure, see in the 2020 iMac update is a T2 chip. The T2 chip is a security chip that helps with things like data encryption, and on the MacBook Pro, it helps with storing all of your, you know, fingerprint data for Touch ID. We don't really need Touch ID security on the iMac because it doesn't have Touch ID, it probably never will, it doesn't really need it. But I think it would still be nice to have the T2 for that additional security for your data and stuff like that, so we'll probably see that. Also, Apple, I kinda just need to have a heart-to-heart with you for a quick second. Listen, man, I love you and everything, but for the love of Steve Jobs, get rid of the frickin' mechanical hard drives. Holy crap, as of today, guys, April 23rd, 2020, the iMac is the only Mac you can buy from Apple's website that still has a mechanical hard drive option. Also, we will likely see a spec bump with the GPU, just like we will with the CPU. Not 100% sure what we'll get, but all you need to really know is it's gonna be a little bit faster and get you a little more bang for your buck. That's really all I care about. Okay, so we talked about the display a little bit earlier. Let's go back to that. Yes, I do miss our good old CRT displays, but that's not what we use anymore. So the iMac comes in a couple different options. There's the super low-end option, which is a 1920 by 1080. Then you have the Retina 4K and the Retina 5K. And you have the 21.5-inch models and the 27-inch models. And the 4K and the 5K also have the P3 wide color, which is great. I'm cool with all that. But I think a nice additional feature to have would be the True Tone display. And True Tone basically looks at the ambient lighting inside of your room and it adjusts the temperature of your display to match it. You have it in the iPad, you have it in the MacBook Pros, heck, you even have it in the Pro Display XDR. So it would be cool to see that in the iMac, but if that's not in there, to me personally, that wouldn't be a deal breaker. So now let's talk more about the potential design for the computer. And before we get into it, I just want to thank Greg from Greg's Gadgets for kind of giving me the final bit of inspiration I needed to make this episode, because he also did a video about the upcoming iMac, so I highly recommend checking that out as well. So thank you, Greg. Anyway, let's talk about the design a bit. Again, I don't think we're gonna see an all new design for the 2020 iMac, but possibly in 2021. However, I decided to make a concept anyway. I borrowed inspiration from the Pro Display XDR. I would like to see that chin go away, first of all.
We lovingly call this the chin.
And if you look at the inside of the iMac, you'll see there is a lot of open space in there, and I'm sure Apple has their reasons for that. But if they could get rid of that chin, that would be awesome. In fact, that's something I was honestly hoping for back in like 2012. But if they do keep the chin, or maybe meet me halfway and make the chin smaller, that's okay too. It's not a deal breaker. My concept doesn't show an Apple logo on the front either. Again, I was borrowing inspiration from the Pro Display, but if the final product has one on the front, I'm okay with that too. Thinner bezels would also be pretty nice. I would like to see that. I'm not expecting the chassis to be like the Pro Display XDR with like the cheese grater holes and all that stuff. I don't think that's necessary, at least yet. And as for the foot, I think the foot is gonna stay the same. It's not gonna be like the Pro Display with the Pro Stand, just because, well, let's be honest, if Apple's gonna charge $999 for that Pro Stand, I would rather them not add that into the iMac, increasing the cost potentially. I would rather just them keep it the way it is right now. I think it looks good. So there are some iffy rumors about bigger features for 2020 at least, but really I think we'll see more of that stuff later because guys, we're just getting started. I think 2021 is gonna be a big update year for Apple. I don't know how the whole coronavirus thing is gonna delay that stuff, but I think we're gonna see some big stuff. But hey, either way, a guy can dream, right? So that's why I made some concepts. It's fun. So let me know what you think in the comments down below because I am always curious. And if you want to get more stuff from me and more bonus goodies from the Computer Clan, go ahead and click that join button down below and you can unlock some of that cool stuff. It's all new and shiny, so go ahead and check that out. And thanks for sticking with me. Catch the crazy and pass it on.